This practical session about the external and internal features of the heart. We start with the external features of the heart. The heart has three surfaces and three borders. It has right border, left border, and inferior border. And it has three surfaces. The anterior surface, which is called sternocostal, according to its related structures. In this surface, we can see the right atrium, the right ventricle, the left ventricle. The inferior surface of the heart, which is formed by the left ventricle and the right ventricle. The posterior surface of the heart, which is formed mainly by the left atrium and a small portion by the right atrium. On the anterior surface, we can see this groove which separates the two ventricles and lodges the anterior interventricular artery and the great cardiac vein. And appear also the coronary groove, which separates the atrial portion from the ventricular portion of the heart. On the left side of this groove, we can see the branches of the left coronary artery, the circumflex, and the anterior interventricular artery. On the right side, in the same groove, we can see the right coronary artery run towards the left or right border of the heart. Now, we open the right atrium to see the internal features of this chamber of the heart. We have four openings. The first is the opening of the superior vena cava. The second, inferiorly, is the opening for the inferior vena cava. The third is the right atrioventricular opening, which is guarded by the tricuspid valve. And we can see here the coronary sinus opening. Also, inside the right atrium, we can see this fossa, which is called fossa ovalis. And we can see part of the pectinate muscle, which represent rough surface of the anterior part of the right atrium. And this smooth area is called sinus venarum, which is developed from the sinus part, sinus venosus part of the right atrium. We open now the anterior part of the two ventricles to look to the internal features of the two ventricles. The first is the presence of projected muscular part of the interior of the right ventricle called papillary muscles. Their tips is attached by fibrous strands called cordae tendinae to the margins of the cusps of the valve. They are three on the right side. The same papillary muscles is present on the left side. And it has also cordae tendinae attached to the bicuspid valve. We can see the lower part of the two ventricles is rough and the upper part is smooth. It is called infundibulum on the right side and called vestibule, which give exit for the great arteries which emerges from the two ventricles. The pulmonary trunk on the right side and the aorta on the left side. Posteriorly, these are the four pulmonary veins which coming from the both lungs and open into the left atrium.